Go.
Hi, we're going to show how you turn a bushel of tomatoes into about 8 quarts of sauce. I couldn't find a video online, so I'm making my own in case you're interested in doing it. I'm a third generation Italian, and I love sauce and love pasta, so this is what I like to do, and my wife can't stand it because it makes a mess. So we took it into the garage this year. This is, we're like 99% through the job, but anyway, this is a bushel of tomatoes. It's about 50 pounds. You can get it for about $20, and you have to use the Romas. If you use anything else, you'll get a bucket of water. There's way too much water. This is why Italians use these tomatoes. They're much meatier. So you take your tomatoes from the bushel, you put them in the barrel. You put them in the barrel, you rinse them off good, and you, in the process, you'll sort them as well, because you're going to have some bums, and because of the storm, these sat, so we probably had about a dozen or two that we had to give to the chickens. So once you pick out your batch, and then you core them, get yourself a good knife so you're not fighting it the whole time. These knives are like 30 bucks if you get a good one. Save your waste. That's the corings from about a bushel. And then what we're doing is quartering the tomatoes. And they fit right into the grinder. Now we use this was my big debate this year. Last year we used a food mill, which has that crank that it skims everything out. What you're trying to do here is take out the seed and the skin from the tomato. We were blanching last year and peeling by hand. It was tedious, but we must have done, I don't know, 3 bushels anyway. It was quite a bit of work. We had tons of jars of sauce, and we gave a lot away. It was really fun, and we got probably half of those back. But we still have, three, 4 dozen jars to work with. So anyway, so we got, I decided that what I was going for was the Squeezo strainer grinder rig. And what everybody will tell you is, yeah, we did tomatoes, but it was a lot of work, and they do this, and it's because they're grinding the whole time. This is the only rig that connects to a motor that I could find without paying a fortune. It's about 20 bucks for the food tray attachment. I think it's 30 or 40 for the grinder rig, and then you add on this strainer. And all this is the heart of any tomato strainer. It's our food mill. It's this rig here. So there's a screw inside here. There's a corkscrew inside here that mashes everything through, and then you get this sauce over here. This is just the pulp though. You don't have to do this, it just sits there anyway. So here's the components. So that goes on there. And this again you get from anybody that sells KitchenAid. And it's nobody else's machine will connect to the KitchenAid motor, which doesn't make any sense because all it is a hex on the end and they could connect without any infringement. But they don't do it, so whatever. So here's how it works. The tricky thing is, and they all have this, is you got to plunge it, you got to stuff it in the hole, you got to push it through. So turn it on full power. We quartered 1, 2, 3, and this is how you'll spend a couple hours for a bushel. You push it through, get down here, and basically what's coming out is like a juice, is what it looks like. And the interesting part is, yeah, there it goes. Okay, so that's going to become your sauce there. Now, here's the coolest thing. This is what saves a lot of time. All the waste comes out the end. It does not blend together. It separates it perfectly. That's what you want. You don't want to be doing that by hand. This is still half the time of doing it by hand with a hand crank food mill. And all your skin and seed comes out. And what you're looking at is about half in that bucket, half of the waste from a bushel.
Okay.
And then the last step is to turn it into sauce. And again, this year, can you come this way? So there's the product you get. It's a little pulpy. It's not Pastene yet. But you'll just boil it down, and we went with an outdoor burner this year, again, to get it out of the kitchen, and it heats up pretty good. So Now I'll probably spend like an hour boiling it down, and you can kind of see it's very watery, and still that's only half as watery as what you'd get out of a normal tomato that you'd serve at the table. So that's it, and so I use the KitchenAid accessories, and we'll probably do about 3 bushels again this year and jar most of them. Good night.